we met, what'd you think I was gonna be?
The biggest goddamn drug dealer in New York City. Escape from what?
I don't know any old wrinkled drug dealers. They're either dead or inside. Tasha, that doesn't scare you?
Send Tommy away. You're the only one standing in the way of what you want with Tasha, right?
Where's the gun?
With Tariq.
Where's Tariq?
With Kanan.
With Kanan?
Yes. I ain't got to help you with shit.
Tasha, come on. This Tommy thing ain't going nowhere. It's not gonna be good for anyone. You know that, Tasha.
Not this time, Ghost.
What do you mean?
You made this mess. You fix it. All right, Tariq. I'm gonna teach you the game. Sorry.
But you never loved this version of me standing in front of you, now did you? Remember? The biggest goddamn drug dealer in New York City. That's who the fuck you loved.
What's up with glass niggas? It's your boy J Miles, and I am back with another video. And you know what to do. If you're new, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, leave a like, comment, and most importantly, share with your ugly ass friends. But today's video, I will be covering Tasha St. Patrick, aka Tasha Green, is the devil of the is the devil of the power universe and the fall of the Ghost Empire. That is correct. Tasha is the real villain of the power universe. A lot of folks be letting her off the hook and stuff, not really paying attention to what's going on. But I see your ass, Tasha. You chocolate sexy motherfucker. You've been doing a lot of damage, and I'm about to expose you today. But on today's video, I will be covering all of the things that Tasha has done that ultimately made everything fall apart. So Tasha has a big part in the reason why a lot of it, you know, just crumbled. And she could have prevented a lot of it, but she was so caught up in her emotions that, like a lot of women typically do. So I know a lot of my female subscribers, y'all probably going to tag me heavy on this one. But hey, I'm prepared. Because I'm telling y'all, she did it. But this also will be a two-part series. Because there will be another villain that will be revealed. This is part one. But without further ado, let's get into the video. So, as always, you know how I do. I post my clips that's at the beginning that's letting you know that's going to, support my theory. And we're going to start with the first clip. So, the first clip comes from episode one of season one. So, the very first episode. This is when Ghost is talking with Tasha. And he asks her, when we met, what did you think I was going to become? And she responded, the biggest goddamn drug dealer in New York City, right? So, right there, if you pay attention to, if you're a fan of Power and the way Ghost move, Ghost pretty much always gives everyone a chance. If you pay attention, like when he talked about Breeze, when, he first killed Breeze, he was saying that he gave Breeze a chance before he killed him, but Breeze didn't change his mind. So, it was the same thing here with Tasha and his marriage, you feel me? He was giving Tasha a chance. He was like, look, this drug thing is cool and all, but we need to be trying to, you know, get out too. So he was, but right then he just asking her, what did she think of him? And pretty much she revealed to him that she just see him as a drug dealer. And so almost like she just see him as a slot machine. Like, goddamn, it ain't that. Oh, I knew you was going to be a great father, or I feel protected when I'm around you, or it was your ambition or it was your intelligence. None of that shit. Her thing she thinking about is that he was going to be the biggest goddamn. Like, goddamn, that's the same thing. She the same person that's scouting, waiting on the next NBA player to, you know, hit the draft. So, and then get with him so that, you know what I'm saying, so she can get with the ballers. That's what it sounds like. Because if that's all you're thinking about, like, your first thing is not that, you know, something, a good attribute of him. Like, you just see him as he was going to be the biggest drug dealer. Like, goddamn. So, way she talking, you ask me, if Zeke was around in this time,
if he was there for the draft, if she knew he was going to the draft,
she would have motherfucking been with Zeke. Goddamn. But, yeah, anyway, though, on the, like, the next clip, same thing, you know what I'm saying? Ghost, this is him giving her the second chance. You feel me? The second chance. He's like, look, I don't know any old, wrinkled drug dealers, which is, he is right. Like, he was like, they either dead or inside. And he was like, they don't scare you? And she gonna respond back and be like, no, what? Because they not as good as you. Like, any, like, that's also, you know what I'm saying, questions her as a mother too, because as a mother of three kids, you should be thinking, okay, you know what, Ghost is smart as hell. Look at this empire he's created, right? So if he was able to do this and I help him with this nightclub shit, I think he really can do something with this, and then our family will be protected. You know what I'm saying? Tariq would have never got to the bad path that he went down because they would have been legit. Tariq then probably never would have found out about all the other stuff. Even if he did find out about it, he would have looked at it differently because he never seen his dad or his mom doing, you know what I'm saying, illegal activities. So the odds of Tariq going down a bad path like that would have been significantly lower if Tasha would have just supported him like a good wife supposed to did. Because any one of them could have been killed or arrested at any time. But she wasn't thinking about that. All she was thinking about is the money. Then the craziest part, she later on get with Terry Silver talking about she want to go legit. Bitch, that what he was trying to get you to do from the beginning. But anyways, the next clip. Now, some might be saying, so why you push this one in here, glad nigga? Well, I'm going to tell you, glad nigga. Yeah, Tasha wasn't in this scene directly, but Tasha is the reason why Sean got killed. That's why I said it. Tasha is the reason Sean was killed. And how is that? Look at the clip. Kanan was letting them know right there. She the Ghost, the only one in the way of what Sean wants with Tasha. Well, first off, Tasha should have never been messing around with no damn Sean. And don't y'all get in y'all feelings and get in these comments and be like, she can choose whoever she wants. Yeah, boy, you telling me you gonna choose the motherfucker that Ghost been raising as his son damn near, who damn near is his son, but that's another video. If you ain't checked out my video yet about Ghost being Sean's dad, go ahead and check that out. But anyways, like, you gonna choose him of all the other dudes that you could have chose? Then she went down. Like, how you gonna go down? Ghost this balling ass nigga, and then you go down to a high school basketball coach. You don't even know how to do it right. See, she even bad at that. It did. I mean, at least she got a little smarter when she went up to Terry Silver. That was at least a little step higher. But goddamn. But you know what I'm saying? But my point is, Sean would have never tried or even attempted, you know what I'm saying, to think about killing Ghost if she wasn't, you know what I'm saying, doing what she was doing with him behind Ghost's back. If she would have never gave him no play, Sean would have still been a good kid. He probably would have said no to Kanan. And Kanan wouldn't have killed him. He just been like, okay, my son ain't about that life, which he already knew anyways. You feel me? But since Tasha did do that, he got that extra motivation to do something that he knew he wasn't ready to do. And that ultimately led to Kanan's Sean's death. So, yep, Tasha is responsible for Sean dying too. Next, you got her being responsible for Kanan dying. Well, we all know that. Now, y'all can't deny this one. Even my latest subscribers, y'all can't deny this one. She's definitely responsible for Kanan dying. And she probably was happy about it because we all know she didn't like Kanan. But, she set it up, had Tariq in a car, and she really was BSing a little bit too, because you think about it. Ghost style, it instantly clicked in his head. It was like, look, Kanan is a motherfucker with himself. Kanan, like, ain't no telling. Them cops may not get to him in time before he killed Tariq, which could have happened, actually. Well, only thing saved Tariq was that Kanan had a heart and didn't still love Tariq, even though, you know, he betrayed them and let him go. But you know what I'm saying? Like, so she could have got her son killed right there, but she, you know what I'm saying? It's like, what's his name? Charleston White. White said, women are loyal to their emotions. And she got emotional and wanted Kanan dead or wanted him arrested. I get it that it could have helped their situation and stuff like that, but at the end of the day, she made a very crazy decision, you know what I'm saying? And that ultimately led to Kanan being killed. Anyways, next, you got the next clip. So this is season 6 of episode 1. Now, a lot of y'all might be saying, how is that Tasha's fault? Well, all right, I'm going to tell you a glad niggas. So, right here, Ghost was begging Tasha to basically, you know, try to go and make amends with Tommy. He was like, he knew it wouldn't be a good idea if he showed up and tried to do it. So, he was like, okay, Tasha is the liaison of us, both of us, between, because, you know, she's the mutual party between both of us. So if Tasha go and talk to Tommy, maybe we can defuse this before it gets too bad. Because that tells you there that Ghost really didn't want to kill Tommy. Like, he really didn't even want to go that far because he still loved him. That's his brother. You feel me? But ultimately, after Tasha decided that she's not going to help him with it, he like, okay, it's either me or him. Because he wasn't sure whether or not Tommy was still trying to kill him or not. So he was like, hey, if that's the case, he already done took one shot. I'm about to take that nigga out. So, and so that means she's responsible for what happened with Tommy and Ghost. Because she could have helped defuse it, but she was in her emotions, mad about some Terry Silver, another nigga that you ain't got no business messing with either. And matter of fact, that's another body added to it, Terry Silver. That one added on you too. Now, I know a lot of y'all, how is that? How is it? Don't y'all get up in these comments and start acting up. Don't y'all do that. She is responsible for that shit. You want me to tell you why? Because why in the world are you messing with another nigga that your husband is involved with? Why can't you go and find, like, it's all them niggas up in New York. And you going to go and just find the two niggas that your husband is involved with. One of them that he raised and another one that's a lawyer that helped him get off. You couldn't go and find somebody else? Like, you should have known he was going to take a slight to that. But you didn't give a damn. Because why? Because you loyal to your emotions. But anyways, our next clip. Now she over there telling her son she going to teach him the game. What? Now I get it. A lot of y'all going to be like, well, she just did that because he was going to do it anyway. I ain't going to lie to you. I agree with you to a certain extent with that. But, hey, at the end of the day, she shouldn't have made that decision without involving her father, his father, which was Ghost. Ghost probably never would have agreed to that shit. But the point is, you should have did it, and y'all could have came together and came up with a solution instead of going behind his back trying to teach Tariq that shit. And that's kind of what ultimately led Tariq to go ahead and do what he did, in a way. I ain't gonna put that all the way on her, but hey, she get a little small piece of that pie. Next, she gonna kill Lakeisha. Now this 100% on her. You can't blame no. I mean, Tariq get a little bit of that blame too, but We ain't talking about Tariq right now. We talking about you, Tasha St. Patrick. Green. You gonna shoot Lala and her bad acting. Laid her bad acting ass on out on the floor like that. Tommy getting ready to marry her and stuff. He all happy. Then he see her laying in the floor. He gotta tell Lil' Cass and his bad acting ass to go back in the car. Because he see her laid out, laid out flat with her brains blown out. Come on, Tasha. You don't took a mother from him. And now you making Lil' Cass grow up without a mom. Come on, man. That's another one. I told you, Tasha doing damage in these streets. But anyways, in our last clip, we got the ending scene. This is the last episode, and this is Ghost and Tasha's last scene. I actually love this scene. But pretty much right here, she's asking him, did you ever really love me, or was that all a lie? And Ghost pretty much let her know, no, I loved you, little hoochie. But the thing is, you a bullshit. You ain't never loved a real nigga that's sitting right here in front of you. Remember? The biggest goddamn drug dealer in New York City. That's who the F you love. You know what I'm saying? So, pretty much, you are the reason that Ghost was led to the path that he's on now. It could have been y'all. He could have been lieutenant governor, and you could have been the what? The second lady of the state. But no, you want to be in your feelings talking about you want him to be a drug dealer. And that's the only reason why he ultimately went to Angela. If you would have just been loyal as a wife and supported his dream, there never would have been an Angela. Now, a lot of y'all probably going to hit these companies like, he was going to do that anyway. How y'all know it, lad, nigga? You don't know that. He gave her two chances, just like he gave Breeze. And she failed, just like Breeze did. You know what I'm saying? So, ultimately, he chose Angela. And with Breeze, ultimately, he chose to take him out. So, that's all I got for y'all, you know, in today's video, man. I hope y'all enjoyed it. But, you know, like always, if you're cool with me, fool with me, man, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Leave a like, comment. And make sure you share it with your ugly ass friends. But yeah, man. Like I told y'all, Tasha, she was the demon. She was the villain. She's the reason that it all fell apart. At least she's one half of it. Now tune in for part two, where I will reveal the second half of the devil of the power universe that ultimately made everything crumble. But until next time, I'm out.